GBETV.
Yes, sir!
Yes, people! It's your boy Shabini, and you're watching In the Street with Shabini. And today, my guest is recording Guyanese artist Trayvon Vibe. Right, Trayvon Vibe? Big up yourself, sir. Let's check out this interview right now. Right now, check it out. Trayvon Vibe.
Sir, welcome to GBETV, man.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Everything nice, good, man. Good. Everything good.
How are you, man? How are you?
What I say, happy.
Just stay happy. How are you doing?
Trusting God. That's the way I do it, man. Just keep trusting God and making sure that everything is legit with your family, close friends.
So let's go from the beginning, man. Where you from?
Guyana.
Guyanese.
Sweet Guyana.
But you don't talk like the raw Guyanese.
I was born in Linden Mackenzie Hospital.
Right.
I ran a boat for 1 year in Blueberry Hill.
Okay.
Richmond Hill.
Right.
And then my mom decided that she wanted to take me to Barbados. So I ended up living in Barbados 24 years.
24 years in Barbados. Yeah. So you live Guyana 1 year old, 2 years?
1 year old.
1 year old. Grew up in Barbados.
Yeah.
So why didn't claim the beach? And
because what is called my neighbor's string? My neighbor's string?
Cutting GT.
Cut and buried in Guyana.
Alright. And how long have you been doing music?
I mean, doing music, I would say about, I don't want to, like, I would say like, professionally,
professionally,
I would say at least 5 years.
5 years? Well, congratulations.
For 5 years.
Because a lot of men working 5 years and I ain't meet the level you at.
But I won't say I reach at any kind of level.
No, man. There's a lot of men with this business doing 5 years and not get the numbers you get here. You don't feel that way?
Well, you know, I don't really watch on what really going on with me.
I peep the scenes.
I don't really worry on what's going on with other people because they got my own struggles. So I don't really watch on it. But if to some people, to them, they believe that I reach a certain way, fasting and something, I advise you to go to church.
You believe in the Most High. You sound like you're strong.
I tell you all this, God is good.
You're a strong believer.
That's what I do. That's where my success comes from.
I agree. I don't believe. I know there's a Most High. You know, it's a difference when you believe.
True.
And I know there's a Most High, so I go off of that, you know. Who inspired you, man?
To do what? To write
music? Yeah.
I would say everything that wronged me, you know. Everything that's happening in life is really make me want to find words to put into my music. Because as a child now, I wasn't able to express myself the way I want to express myself. Some children up there struggling with doing that. So some kids are actually struggling with actually everything that's going on in their life. But they don't know how to come to somebody and say, well, this is what's going on, this scary. So me now, I was scared to tell my family maybe the things I've been doing at that point in time, so I decided to put it into music.
Now, why you was afraid to approach your parents? Or
because not everything that I've been doing as a child may have been positive. But look at me now.
So you turned that around?
I turned my whole lifestyle around because of music. Let me take off this because people might wonder who's speaking. Hello.
Right.
Yeah, so I don't, everything that going on with me, it's basically I put music and I put God with it. I try to express myself and all of my problems through music. Even my fun times, and most of my songs are happy songs because I don't want to give people no depression.
So that's your genre, that you want people to be happy. That's your message.
Yes, that's what I really want to do, make people happy. When people hear my voice, they must see a joy in listening to my music. You know, the message always must be something nice.
But music also show negativity that, you know, like you said, if you write from your experience of life, there are certain people that have been through some rough times, you know, and showing people that what they had to do to survive. Not that they're proud of it, but can that not be used as a positive tool also?
Yeah, a lot of people use it, but you see, that's not also, I don't want to sing those things that happened in my past, because then for years I have to hear them because they will be hits. And I don't want to think about my negative. I don't want my negative thinking. In your ears, in his ears, my negativity is like, yeah. In my ears, my negativity is
right,
like,
right, remember. Right. Makes sense.
Cool, that's why.
That makes sense. I respect that.
Yeah.
5 years professionally, yeah. Next 5 years, what you look into?
What I look into? Next 5 years, I want to give back to the community. That is my goal, actually. I grew up with a mom alone, so it was really tough. Mm. It was really hard to be in a house where mom is working two or three jobs, trying to support me and trying to support my brother and my sister and my younger sister. So I want to try to help mothers out there that are struggling to have an education to give to the kids. So I'm trying as a youngster now to be great, so that I don't want to see famous, but I just want to be so great that when I start to actually reach where I want to be in life, I could take my money and try to help those females out there that need that, because some men don't live up to the responsibilities that they're supposed to.
That's big, that's big, that's deep. Yeah. Well, I wish you all the best on that, man. That's real deep, that's real deep. Mm-hmm. Share with me, man, like, we're Guyana, Barbados, Guyana.
Yeah.
I feel right. This is my take on this. Mm-hmm. Guyanese don't get the reputation they need when it comes to music. Bajan do, right? People accept Bajan. Why didn't you choose that route to go and then later on say, because you stand up hard for Guyanese. If you understand,
I just fight 100% for Guyana.
Right.
And you see, what people don't understand is that, yeah, I may live 24 years in Barbados, right, but that's not where your heart is, you know? You gotta understand that you have to follow your heart in life. If you don't follow that voice in that heart in life, you wouldn't be where you're supposed to be. And that voice that's speaking to your head is God. Some people may hear God talking to them and may not listen, but they will follow whatever the brain telling them, but not really what the heart saying. Right. You understand? I'm always following my heart. So when I hear that voice, I'm always being successful at everything I want because I listen to that voice and I be obedient to the voice. Some people may say, oh, you sound like a madman. You listen to voices in your head. But really and truly.
But people with overstanding don't think you sound like a madman.
Correct. People with overstanding. And if you don't know overstanding me, it means understand.
Right. Well, I understand before you could overstand. So when you're speaking these positive things, I'm with you, right?
Yeah.
And that's great stuff.
So that is really and truly what you gotta be smart in what you're doing.
I respect that, man. I respect it. Sound like a real positive dude. That means you do some real bad things.
No, kids at home that may be watching this video, I have never, ever did anything that is wrong. When people look at me and they get a different feeling, they may think, oh, this may be a negative guy. Or he look like, oh, he don't like hanging around nobody, he gonna be real antisocial. But isn't that simply it says surround yourself with positive people.
Right.
And you will become successful.
Right.
Anything that you have around you is what makes you. So if you're a good man, I'm your friend, then for sure I will be a good man.
Right.
But if I walk around with a gun in my waist,
you're gonna attract that.
I attract negativity. If you plant a lime tree and the lime drop and the seed scatter, what grows next to it?
Lime tree. Right. Positive dude, energy right. Mama taught you well, man.
Struggle and my mommy taught me well. I don't want to say the streets. Some kids may say, yeah, boy, go for the streets.
Right.
I would just say struggle.
Okay. How many siblings you have?
I would say nine.
Nine. Where are you for?
I be second to last.
Second to last. Yeah. You don't want to do music?
No, everybody does. My sister is an artist also. She does mostly gospel and she wins a lot of competitions in Barbados. Big up to Shanaka.
Okay.
I used to mock her to sing and that's really high pitch came from.
Okay.
Straight up. Okay. Then my brother actually is an African dancer. He dances African music, so it's in a culture. My little sister does the same thing.
When you get to that next level, right?
Yeah.
Are you one of those artists who are going to dig back for younger artists? Because I could call some people that don't do it, that make it, you understand? Do you look forward to work with younger artists too?
Well, when I make it, and the road to making it is very long because you're always learning.
Right.
As you go, so you never make it because the more you get something, the more you want something else. But yes, well, I'm on that journey and I have the time to bring up somebody that also have the same talent as me and really want it as much as I do. I will help them, you know? At this point in time, I'm still fighting to become successful.
Right.
I can't just say, oh, I may have been made it to Guyana. Or to some people.
Right, that's what I was speaking about.
Some people don't even know me, but I may have made it to some people.
Right.
And to some people I have not. To me, I am making it yet.
Right, because your goal might be...
So I can't go right now and just help another guy.
Right.
I myself need help. Make sense? You know what I mean?
Jamaican artists, which one you would like to work with?
Jamaican? One? I like all of them, man.
Yeah, but choose one.
Yeah,
number one.
I would like to work with Idonia.
Idonia,
Reason I say Idonia is because Idonia has a special talent that is incredible, which I see he could mix it on any beat and make it into his style. And that's something that I am good at doing. I take any beat and make it money.
American artists.
American artists, Michael Jackson, died, but rest in peace. Can't do that. Other than Michael, I would say anyone that come my way, you know. Anyone that come my way would work with once they have a good background and know exactly what they're doing. I mean, because I don't want to end up falling. Some artists pick the wrong person to lead them.
As a Guyanese artist, I know for a fact.
Yeah.
It's easier for a Jamaican artist, right? You agree or disagree?
Yeah.
So
I don't want to agree or disagree, but it may be easier because their voice is recognized to it.
So yeah. What are some of the struggles? I'm asking you this, right? Because of one younger artist, they hear the struggles so they know what they're gonna deal with. What are some of the struggles as a Guyanese artist go through?
The struggles that we go through as Guyanese artists, I think it's some of us is just getting the education, you know? It's just getting the knowledge. I think we need to just sit back and try to learn the thing more. That's just, and I know some may disagree. I mean, like, everybody don't have the same mindset. But for me, I think we just need to sit back and try to learn more and be creative and practice and practice and practice, and we can get it right. You know, we will have the right way to make our sound or whatever.
So, for me, right, from me outside looking in, I think we need more major outlets. I think that's one of the things. Of course, like you said, a lot of artists need to do their homework, right? Not every artist that say they're artists.
Me, like me too. I'm just speaking on me and maybe some of them, you know? Mm-hmm. Me know everything. And we know we ain't even superstars yet. So we still learning. And as I said before, as you go, you learn more. I mean, you see, you're always learning. So I guess we just at this stage and we going up. We could be recognized soon.
Definitely. Oh yeah, definitely.
Not that we are not recognized, because I sure Trinidad and I sure Barbados watching on and realize that we talented.
Right.
I know that. Well, some of them get vexed, but I went to school in Barbados, so what? You understand what I mean? I know a lot of them watching on and saying, yo, that artist, they're bad, yo. And it's a Guyanese, it's just that they may not know. The sound isn't recognized. So our music is good, but the sound may not be recognized.
And that's one of the problems. I put that in my notebook. I think you hit a nail right here. The sound's not recognized, so it's not easy. So people to grab it,
known. A lot of people know us, because there are times I walk in on the street and people that I don't even know, they say, hey, Vibes!
Right. They're recognizing your music.
And they be like, I'm like, hey, what's up? But that was a Trini person or a Lucian person just shout me. But wait, where you know me from? Oh, I heard your music on YouTube. Or site advertising on Facebook. Like, okay, nice to supporting the music, man. That's what I mean, they're recognized, you know?
So how far you think we at to get to a superstar level?
Like, a superstar?
Yeah.
If you won't believe you're a superstar, you heart is a superstar.
To the world.
I don't want to say, oh, we got this amount to reach. You could turn a superstar overnight. Overnight, somebody could hear my music now and say, ooh, that sound good. Right. Send it to some big radio station. They play it once. Somebody called, oh, play that song there again. And it keeps playing moving. Guess what? Tomorrow I become a superstar. It's just timings. God is knowing he's going to show me things to make it work.
You just got to keep doing the work. Any final thought where the people could meet you?
Oh, to find me actually on Facebook, Trevon Vibes, TrevonVibez, or VIBEZ. And then same thing on Instagram,
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the man himself,
Trevon Vibe.
You know.
Y'all I see the money, my take a no say you stop it. Anytime I bubble up, you know you have to get it. 9 months later, so you get a little bit.
Hey.
Check on my tongue and I got a little bit.
Hey. Hey.
I know what she wants. When she give me love, so she need me. See the funny thing, I just believe it. When you want to buy that, you're crazy. Are you me one? Are you me? See the on my body, baby.
What? Build it on the spot. Drink it. Vibe. Bless up yourself, sir.
That is why I'm so good. Because it doesn't take me a day, 2 weeks. It takes me a couple minutes to write one song.
Mm. On this program, we say progress is a must. Slow progress better than no progress, right? So, sir, keep up the progress. Good luck in your career, all right?
God is good. Remember that.
Trevon, bless up yourself, sir. It was a pleasure meeting you, dude. Real calm, humble person, dude. Bless up yourself, people. That was my interview with Trevon. Follow the guy, share his music. Let's get his message out there, all right? Thank you for watching. Progress is a must. Slow progress better than no progress. It's your boy, Shabini. I'm out. GBE TV. Yes, sir!